Good morning. Welcome to Palm Sunday. We sing about God's amazing grace. Sing with us today.
still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never fail me yet.
Hello, New Hope. Dan Morey here. I just wanted to share with you the song that is my go-to song in good times and in bad times. It's just such a simple and basic song about where our thoughts, where my thoughts go each and every day and where they should go as Christians. So here we go. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Thank you. Stay safe and stay healthy.
So I want to thank the music team for serving us well with the songs. Again, it's truly, truly soul good. You know, I always like to play with words in that, not just S-O good, but just S-O-U-L, soul good, to see them, to hear them, to sing along with them. So can I ask you to send them, for those that you know, send them a text, send them an email, send them a note, just thanking them and telling them, again, how so good it was to see them. Speaking of notes, I want to share a note that we got in this week. It just says this: we are so thankful and blessed by all that you are doing to encourage and support us during this time. We are also amazed and thankful for how New Hope Church and School have blessed us throughout the 20 years that we've been a part of the New Hope family. We know that our marriage is stronger, our family is healthier, and our faith is more solid because of New Hope. We love you, and we love New Hope Ministries. We pray that God will continue to bless the New Hope family for many, many more years with love. And again, we'll leave it anonymous. Would you pray with me, please? So, gracious God, here we are. It's Palm Sunday, and we never anticipated that we would ever celebrate a Palm Sunday like we're doing this day behind our screens. Whether we have it projected up on a smart TV, whether it's on our phone or on our laptops, we're just thankful that we have this technology and that we can be together on this Palm Sunday following you, Jesus. So we want to continue to trust you, God. We want to continue to be wise. We want to continue to be feeding our faith and starving fear. So Lord Jesus, will you continue to help us to walk with you and to follow you through all the days of April as we are sheltering in place? We know that we are serving our fellow humans, the men, the women, especially those that are the most vulnerable. So help us to have that strength and help us to do it together. Again, we're following you, we're trusting you, we're being wise, and we pray this all in your name, Jesus. Amen. So again, I just wanted to say a couple more things, and then we're going to read the gospel for this Palm Sunday. One of the accounts, actually all four gospels have an account of the Palm Sunday. We're going to read it from John, who usually kind of goes his own way, but even for Palm Sunday, he comes to this. So again, just our staff here, I want you to know just how proud I am, and I know that they're reaching out to many of you. That you get this video is from the hard work of our staff, especially with Steve, the music team that came in, and Emily is providing things for our youngest children. Sarah is working hard with our middle schoolers, our high schoolers. They're in contact. Well, they're always in contact with all the social media stuff. Angie continues to work very, very hard to do all the things that need to happen financially. And so that is definitely keep her in your prayers and just all that's going on. Brian, our facilities director, is doing a great job with this downtime to get some things even working better for us. So we're just so thankful. They're praying. They're serving. We're preparing. Again, as we all know now, April 30th. So we won't be together for Easter or the Sunday after Easter or the Sunday after that. But we're praying and just preparing for when we will be able to be back together. We're also going to be preparing for Monday, Thursday, Good Friday experiences, again, behind the screen. And we're thinking hard about how we can serve you the best. And then for Easter, Easter happens, whether we're all together in one room or in behind our screens, we will celebrate Jesus being risen. So I just want to keep encouraging us. Let's keep calling one another. Let's keep talking together. Let's keep praying together. We're doing soul care together. And then one more thing, if I could just thank you again and encourage you for your giving. Our leaders have been serving us well. I've been so impressed with Vice President Pence. Not going to get into the whole politics and that, but I've heard him say on numerous occasions, if you are a part of a faith community, please be faithful to get your donations into the faith community. Our faith communities all across America serve our Americans so well, and this is a time to help them to continue to be strong in serving. So thank you for your giving. Thank you for those who have now signed up for online giving. Thank you for those that put your checks in the mail this last week. We've gotten them, and we are, God is moving. I cannot tell you how thankful we are as the staff in the body of this church. We are blessed, and so thank you. Now, why are we so blessed? Well, we are following this Jesus, and today we follow him on this Palm Sunday. So here's what we hear from John chapter 12. It says, the next day, the large crowd that had come to the feast heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, crying out, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel. And Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it, just as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. His disciples did not understand these things at first, but when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things had been written about him and had been done to him. The crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb and raised him from the dead continued to bear witness. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they had heard he had done this sign. So the Pharisees said to one another, You see that you are gaining nothing. Look, the whole world has gone after him. And indeed, the whole world has gone after him, and we are part of that world on this Palm Sunday 2020. Let's pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. I heard these words. It's a girl. Oh, I was so happy. Except when we took her home and she would not sleep. I can tell you, my prayer life improved immensely. Please, God, please, please, please let her sleep. But sometimes I would hold her close. It was the best. But all too fast, she grew. Then I heard these words a couple years later. It's a boy. Oh, I was so happy. Sometimes I would hold him close. It was the best. But all too fast, he grew. And 4 years later, I heard these words. It's a girl. Oh, I was so happy. And sometimes I got to hold her close. It was the best, but all too fast, she grew. Then 10 years ago, in 2010, our first grandchild, a girl, was born. And sometimes I would hold her close. It was the best, And then 7 months later, in 2010, there's a story for another time, but our second grandchild was born, a boy. And sometimes I would hold him close. It was the best. But all too fast, he grew. Then another grandson was born a few years later. And sometimes I would hold him. And it was the best. But all too fast, he grew. And then our son and his wife, 4 years ago, and another grandson, a fourth grandchild, was born. And sometimes I'd get to hold him. And it was just the best. But now all too fast, he's growing. And then 2 years ago, another granddaughter. Oh. And sometimes I still get to hold her. And she falls asleep, and it's just the best. But all too fast, she's going to grow. So why am I telling you about our grandchildren on this Palm Sunday? Well, that's what grandparents do. Do you want to see some more pictures? Actually, I want to give you a picture with you in it. It's a picture of you and your Heavenly Father. It's a picture of what we're going to call a warm embrace of grace. Can you say those words with me? Warm embrace of grace. And I want us to think about this as we go into this message. We can never outgrow our good, good Father's warm embrace of grace. Men, I'm going to ask you to stay with me because it's probably going to get a little uncomfortable. So let me give you another picture and then we will return to the picture of a warm embrace of grace. Remember in high school the climbing rope in the gym? I hated it. I never had the upper body strength. How about you? And did you like the one, two, or three who had the upper body strength to climb the rope? Yeah, me either. I did not like those people at all. I just, Do you know why almost nobody, and maybe nobody, likes religious people all that much? Because religious people are always going, look at me, I'm so good, I'm climbing up to God. What's wrong with you? Why are you so weak? And here's a huge truth for me, for you, really for everybody. The only way any of us are going to get from down here to where the Most High God is this. If at the bottom of that rope, there's some sort of a seat or even a basket that we not only sit, but we just lay in it, and it's not at all by any of our strength. It's only by the strength of the Most High God who's going to lift us into his arms with a warm embrace of grace. So let's go back to the picture of holding babies and little children in our arms. Again, I used to just love coming home to the shrieks when my children were still very young and that, and they'd come in and, Daddy, 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 and they'd come in, they'd go, Uppy, 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 and I'd scoop them up and love on them. But again, you know, if you're a parent, especially if you're a grandparent, just all too fast. Can't do that. So, and some of you know my adult son, Jared. He's much lighter than me, but he's about the same size. And I know I don't have the strength anymore to hold him, nor would he want me to hold him. But we can come to know a God. We can come to know a God in such a way who we will never outgrow. We do not have the strength to hold on to him or to climb up to him. And again, we never will. We know that's true for all people. They're never going to have the strength to do that. And religious people, and sometimes we are all religious people, and we think that somehow we can kind of make God, we can get ourselves to God by our good deeds and by the things that, as long as we're nice to other people, as long as we're maybe nicer than other people, that somehow that's going to, there's no strength in any of us or any person that's going to climb their way into that warm embrace of grace. Again, last week we were talking about Peter when they were in the boat and Jesus wasn't in the boat and he came walking on the water, and when they first saw him, they were all frightened. And then Peter said, "If it's you, Jesus, let me come out." And Jesus, again, with that wonderful gesture, invited Peter to come out of the boat and walk on the water. And we know what happens, right, children? Again, you tell mom and dad what's going to happen when Peter gets out. He's going to start walking. But then we read in Matthew 14 that Jesus immediately reached out his hand and took hold of him with that warm embrace of grace. Let's ask ourselves this question. What does Jesus want us to know about our good, good Father? Again, we read the Palm Sunday reading from the Gospel of John. And in the Gospel of John, there's hardly a chapter that goes by that Jesus is not teaching something about the Father. He wants to give us all kinds of images, all kinds of truths, that the Father has this warm embrace of grace. And again, we can never outgrow that warm embrace of grace. It's just the best. So here's what we read in John chapter 6. Again, Jesus teaching about the Father. These are the words of Jesus. If you've got a Bible with red letters, it's going to be these words are going to be in red. "For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who looks on the Son and believes in him should have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day." That's the promise of Jesus, we'll be raised up into that warm embrace of the Father. In verse 44 in John 6, Jesus kind of says the same thing. "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. The Father is looking to draw us. And then again, Jesus says, "And I will raise him up on that last day." A number of years later, when the Apostle Paul is serving Jesus and writing letters to those early Christians and those early churches and all kinds of places, he writes to the Christians in Colossians, again, one of our favorite books here at New Hope, the Christ in us, the hope of glory, the chosen, holy, and dear love, that's all in Colossians. But look how Paul envisions Jesus in chapter 1, verse 17. It's what Paul writes under this inspiration of the breaths of the Holy Spirit. He's talking about Jesus. "And he is before all things, and in him all things hold together." All things hold together. That's the power of who this Jesus is. So can we envision being held by our good, good Father in a warm embrace of grace? Let's see if we can illustrate it. I got this baby doll, and here's what I've been talking about and thinking about and picturing, that we take a little baby, an infant, again, not a lot of strength, right? But I want us to give three hopes for us to envision. And the first hope would just be this, that we are being held by God's strength, not ours. I'm being held by God's strength, not mine. And my arms aren't wrapped around God and holding on to Him. And if God would let me go, which He never would, I don't have the strength to hold on to Him. That's the first. We're being held by God's strength in this warm embrace of grace. And He wants to hold us there. He wants to hold us. Can we envision that? Can we imagine that? And the second thing is that if we do not want to be held, He will always have open arms waiting for us to repent. If we don't want to be held, He will let us walk away. But He's always there with open arms, ready for us to repent. And what's repent mean? It just means turn and look into our good Father's face and His inviting arms so that He can, and He's just waiting for one word, appi, and He's going to be there and He will hold us close in that warm embrace of grace. And the third thing is this. This is the best place to be, in the Father's warm embrace of grace. There's nothing in this world that's going to replace this. There's nothing in this world that's going to last as long as God, our Father's eternal warm embrace of grace. Here's what we read in Psalm 119. It says this, "Hold me up that I may be safe." So imagine being safe in the Father's arms. So let's wrap up. In our Abba Father's warm embrace of grace, we are held in an eternal strength. We are protected by His mighty right hand. Again, a part of being held in God's warm embrace of grace. When something comes to threaten us, the Father's mighty hand is, no. That's not going to happen. This is my child. They're in my arms. They're in this warm embrace of grace with me. No. Here's what we read in Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." So we are held in a strong, eternal left arm, this warm embrace of grace, and with His right hand extended out against all evil. All evil. God is holding us, and with His right arm, He is protecting us against COVID-19. And even if we were to get COVID-19, and if we were to die, we're going to be held in His warm embrace of grace, because the eternal grace of God is in His arms. And COVID-19 cannot take that away from us. As we are sheltering in place, He's holding us. He's giving us so much as we are sheltering in place. Again, I know that maybe you, like me, have been thinking about, are we fortunate and graced so much beyond anything that we did, that we were born in America and we are sheltering in place in America? When the word came out that 1.3 billion people in India were going to have to shelter in place, I just thought, oh my goodness, how much suffering is there going to be in that country? So again, even as we are sheltering in place, we don't like it. We have a safe place to sleep at night. We have a safe place to be during the day. We have our electricity. We have all of our TVs, our smartphones, our laptops. We can start getting out and walking around. We've got food. We've got water. I mean, we are being held every day with a warm embrace of grace. Again, as we start thinking about the economy, we don't know what's going to happen after this. Some of you are struggling now. And again, we want to keep letting you know, Please, please, please. There's so many of your chosen, holy, and dearly loved brothers and sisters. They are being blessed through this, and they want to serve. They want to give. So let's not do this alone. Let's do this together. So any of you, and any of you have any need, we want you to be able to feel secure in the Father's warm embrace of grace. Again, just going back one more time to that idea of, death is going to come to all of us. But we know the wonder of who this Jesus is. That's why we're walking with him on this Palm Sunday. That's why we're going to follow him on Monday, Thursday, and Good Friday, however that looks this year. And that's why we're going to celebrate Easter. Quite a long time, number of months, maybe years, I'd have to go and look in that. But I shouldn't say it like that. On the first day of Pentecost, which is only a number of like 50 days after, here's some words from Acts chapter 2, verse 24. Peter says this: "But God raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him." That's our Jesus. And what's our Jesus doing when death cannot keep its hold on him? Well, he's lifting us, raising us up into the Father's arms. So who is this Most High God? Well, all 7 billion souls on the earth right now, there's room for each one of those 7 billion, and you are in that 7 billion to be held in this warm embrace of grace. Can I finish with one last uncomfortable invitation again, especially for our spin? If physically able, you don't even have to do it now in the presence of your family, maybe if you're alone and if you're physically able. And no problem if you're not physically able to do what I'm going to invite you to do. You can picture it, you can imagine it, even if it makes you a little uncomfortable at first. But if you would end up kneeling with your arms kind of uppy, but then let them go limp, and put your head into the crook of the Father's neck, and just imagine the warm embrace of grace, no matter what your size, he's got the strength to hold you. It may feel a little uncomfortable at first as an adult, but don't we just love the pictures of a little baby sleeping, being held by a father or by a mother? Can we picture our Heavenly Father holding us? It's just the best. It's just the best. We can picture it, but it's not yet. Not yet. We're going to run, we're going to play, we're going to work, we're going to love, we're going to serve, we're going to suffer some. We're going to keep giving, we're going to keep trusting God, being wise, we're going to feed our faith, we're going to starve our fears, we're going to keep following Jesus, we're going to keep practicing daily 15, we're going to keep gathering every 7, but not too far from now, not too far from now. The best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. Uppy. Oh, I can only imagine this warm embrace of grace. So the other night I was working on this message, and every night a little bit after 9 o'clock, don't know why it comes in a little bit after 9 o'clock at night, I get the YouVersion Bible verse of the day. And so as I was working on this message and wrapping up, I was up a little bit later. Usually I go to bed at 9. I like to get up early and go to bed early in that. But I was up a little bit later, and so I clicked on this verse. And this is the verse that came up, Psalm 68, verse 19. "Blessed be the Lord who daily bears us up. Up. And then the verse says, God is our salvation. The best is yet to come. Up. Will you pray with me, please? So on this Palm Sunday, in Jesus, we remember how you ride into Jerusalem, knowing that by the end of the week, you will be betrayed and you will be crucified. But also you know that 3 days later, the promise of the Father and the Spirit comes true, you'll come back to life, and we know that you do. And we know that one of the reasons that you serve us and suffer for us and sacrifice for us is to bring us into the Father's warm embrace of grace. And there are definitely many days in this life that we live that it's hard to feel the warm embrace of grace of our Father. It's hard to imagine that there is a warm embrace of grace from our Father. But as we continue to follow you, as we continue to serve you, Jesus, 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 you are so good to us, so good to us. So help us to imagine it. Help us to envision it. Help us to practice it. With our arms up and limp and our heads and knowing that it's your strength, your strength, your strength that's holding us. And forgive us when we try to be religious and climb up ourselves. Jesus, as we move into this week, sheltering in place, be with us. Hold us. Help us to do whatever it is that we get to do. If it's off to work, if it's going out for a walk, if it's texting, if it's FaceTiming, if it's having a Zoom call, as we're dealing with our finances, be with us. And help us to know, help us to know, help us to know, you are not going to leave us by ourselves. We are together in this. And so we pray, Jesus, be with us. In your name, amen. Hey, let's enjoy this last song and celebrate the wonder of who this Jesus is as we follow him on this Palm Sunday into this Holy Week. It is still Holy Week. Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, and oh my, it's Friday, but Sundays are coming.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very soul. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. We are your church, Let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand. Heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire. Win this nation back. Change the atmosphere. Build your kingdom here. We pray.
So before Christ in Us, the Hope of Glory, getting that, I just can't say it enough. We're in this together. You're not alone. You're not alone. None of us, me included, like this massive disruption. Man, I wish you were here with me and man, that we were able to do this together and I was able to see your faces and just that we'd be together. Oh, that's the dream that all of us. But I want you to know I'm going to keep reaching out to you. I'm going to keep calling and texting and FaceTiming and Zooming. Then together we can do that. I know the staff is going to keep serving and reaching out. We're in this together. Imagine when we are able to be together again. Oh, what a celebration we're going to have. It will be an Easter Sunday all over again. Every Sunday is a Resurrection Sunday. Every Sunday is an Easter. But until then, never a day without Christ in us, the hope of glory, and a warm embrace of grace. It's the best. The best is yet to come. Love you, New Hope. Love you, chosen, holy, and dearly loved souls.